Exercise 1, User Interface. In this video, we'll be looking at basic navigation techniques, changing views using the tabs and contextual menus, importing files, selecting objects, and orienting to work planes. We'll be looking at different file types. The one we'll be using for this video will be the 01.1 Navigation and User Interface RVT. Navigating the modeling environment. I'll be demonstrating some of the basic navigation tools: pan, orbit, zooming, view cube, and the views menu. To basic pan, you need to use the middle mouse. First, press down and hold the middle mouse. You can pan within the modeling environment. If you would like to orbit, hold shift and the middle mouse, and you'll be able to orbit around your objects. The view cube is also a method for orbiting. You can press and drag while over the view cube and it will begin to orbit around your scene. This method is not as commonly used, and it's usually preferred that you use the middle mouse and shift to navigate around your model. The zooming feature is used by using the scroll wheel on your mouse. And the view cube environment will allow you to have also fixed views perpendicular to the cardinal directions, unless you've changed your orientation, but they will set you to an orthogonal view directly parallel to the elevations. The last item to mention is the browser window. It's located on the left, and it lets you view all of the different views that you have currently in your scene, including other families and things. I'm going to minimize family and schedules just to look at the views that are currently in this project. The 3D render view is a perspective view that's been set up mainly just for rendering. The 3D view with the brackets around it is your actual default 3D view. The new perspective feature in Project Vasari 2.5 is a view type which allows you to edit in perspective. This is different from a camera view where you place a camera to generate the view. When enabled, a new view type is placed in the project browser. To create a perspective working view, go to the Manage tab and click where it says Orthographic, the little arrow underneath it, and choose Perspective View. Now I'm able to edit elements in the scene in this mode. I can select an object and still have the same ability to edit in place, but now when I select a specific element, I have the ability to zoom in a little easier than I would have in a orthographic view. So I'll just turn mine back off just to get back to where I was. The last view is the floor plan 2D site that's been set up to give you a floor plan view. Just note, as you switch between views in the browser window, you'll be opening a new view. There's actually an additional view that opens up. If I click WT to tile, I can see all of the windows I currently have open. As you open new views, it will continually leave the other one still open, and it is a best practice to click on the Close Hidden Windows tool, which is located up at the top of your screen, to be able to minimize how many views are currently open. If you click on Switch Hidden Windows, you should see all the different views you have currently open. I have one view open from a generic project file, and then I have three other views open from this particular file that I am in. To minimize the amount of processing that it needs to act on your video card, it is a best practice to close the hidden windows.